What's going on, legends? My name is Keith Allen, your motivation guy, and today we're gonna break down the evil scientist we all love to hate, Kostik. So this legend specializes in crowd control and fortifying space for your team to fight from. We're gonna talk about his abilities, what kind of team comps work well with him, and more. So definitely sit down and get ready for the first ultimate Kostik guy. First, let's talk a little bit about Dr. Nox. Kostik was one of the 8 original legends in Apex. He was the only purchasable defensive legend, and back then was pretty popular to buy, but many players didn't know how to utilize his kit properly. You know, early on, he was harder to use due to not having fortified, but also other legends were so much better than many players just used different ones. One thing did, and still does make him stronger, is he has no direct counter besides, well, himself. Like, the only way that you're getting into a building with his traps unscathed is by playing Kostik. But even this didn't make him meta until much later on in Season 7. He recently has seen a lot of attention in the form of buffs and nerfs, but Season 10 hit us with some great buffs to his kit and some nice bug fixes. His damage done from his gas is completely different, and now his ult is a little quicker. There were some visual glitches in his gas that have been fixed as well. Alright, so let's take a look at his abilities and what exactly has changed with them this season. Kostik has an entire kit based around defensive traps and poisonous gas that damages and slows enemies. On the surface, he can seem very one-dimensional and only a defensive-oriented character. However, Kostik can really surprise people with strong aggressive pushes reinforced by his defensive abilities. Recent buffs increased his gas damage and reduced his ultimate timer. This makes for a very deadly combination. Alright guys, first up, let's talk about his passive abilities. So the key to Kostik's entire kit lies in his passive. You know, with so much cloudiness caused by all of his abilities, vision is a hard commodity to come by when nearby traps or an ult. This is where Kostik's passive allows any enemies damaged by his gas to be highlighted in a somewhat green version of a digital threat sight. Now, this ability doesn't provide wall hacks as it is blocked by obstacles blocking line of sight. You know, this gives you an incredible advantage over any player in your gas. On top of being a way to change the tide of a battle, it also encourages you to play near your gas as much as possible. You know, an amazing trick to use with this passive in mind is throwing your gas into Bangalore's smoke, as she will be highlighted in her smoke without you having to give up your position. So one thing to be aware of, guys, is that your Nox vision doesn't work against other Kostiks, so always make sure to focus them first in teamfights. And on top of having this amazing threat vision inside of his gas, he also gets the big guy buff, Fortified. This means he's taking 15% less damage from everything, which does help counter his size. Now, this doesn't mean that you should just go strafing in an open field, but it does help those rotations not to be so punishing. Alright guys, so now that we've touched on his passives, let's get into those traps that we mentioned. For more advanced tips like this one, check out our coaches on our website. ProGuides has coaching waiting to help you guys out 24/7. They can help you with practically anything to do with Apex, so do not hesitate. The next step towards improvement. So one of, if not the most time-consuming ability to play against in the game. Nox traps are deployable canisters, which once placed, spew toxic gas when triggered by enemies in their vicinity. So you can throw them a short distance and you charge 3 of them up, but can deploy a maximum of 6 canisters. You get 3 off drop, which is a great way to start the game considering they directly damage enemies. Kostik gas doesn't damage shields at all and completely ignores them. And so with the recent buff, the damage done to enemies increases by 1 point every other 10. This effect doesn't apply to Nox players, as their damage rate is a static 5 per tick. And on top of this, the enemy is getting their screen covered in gas and are being slowed down. These traps are triggered by enemies walking near them, or by you shooting them yourself. This can make for amazing strategies, which we're definitely going to cover later on. Now, these traps are not perfect, as they're able to be shot and destroyed by shooting at or below a line on the bottom of the canister. When the traps are being deployed, they can be shot during the inflation stage, which also destroys them instantly. So the traps can't be destroyed by any of those ways once they are shooting gas though, so sometimes it could be smart to shoot your own trap quicker than the enemy can. So blocking doors or doorways and shooting a trap will ensure that enemies can't come through, which buys you a lot of time. And on top of their obvious uses, you can use them for cover when in a sticky situation. Crouching behind them or placing them in front of you will sometimes give you the perfect amount of cover that you need to win that crucial fight. If you get a knock on an enemy team and decide to push out from the area with all your traps in it, just make sure that you have full charges for redeploying them in the fight. These new traps mark the position to fight from, sort of like a bubble with Gibby. The team can use them for cover or even throw them at nearby enemies while shooting at them to force them out of their position. All right, guys, so up next is the ability that lets him change from defensive turtle to an aggressive skunk, his ult. So the Nox Grenade is what sits in the back of your mind every time you fight a Caustic, just wondering when he's going to throw it on you and ruin all your fun. This ultimate is a grenade that is tossed much like a Gibraltar's defensive bombardment. The effect is essentially a giant Nox trap because everything is the same besides the area of effect is larger. You know, when the grenade hits the ground, the gas fills the surrounding area almost instantly. The cooldown is 3 minutes long, so it definitely is something to use wisely. Getting an opening knock and then throwing the ult in as they're rezzing is a fantastic strategy to use. So the only thing that you need to be concerned about is the Watson ultimate eating yours. Otherwise, it basically can't be countered. Throwing this in large openings with space to move tends to be wasteful with this ult, so try your best to use it in those juicy choke points. Okay, so if you throw your ultimate to push up on a team, make sure that you fortify your new space with more gas traps. This will make you hard to push against if you or your teammates need to heal. So keep in mind, this ability is only damaging the enemy health, so if they are in the ring, then this is extra stressful for enemies. Another fun thing to do with this ult is tossing it inside of a Gibby bubble. This completely negates the bubble and the enemy team is forced to fight outside of it. This, coupled with some traps outside of the bubble, is crucial. Teams will cower in fear from this combo. Alright guys, so now that we've talked about some ways Caustic is great by himself, it's time to talk about team compositions that highlight him. Alright, so when we think about teams that Caustic fits well into, he truly doesn't make a bad choice for almost any composition. And so with that being said, guys, there are a few strong choices that we would like to recommend. With Caustic's abilities and all disrupting enemy and teammate vision, it really helps everybody to have a scanning legend like Seer or Bloodhound. Not only are you getting that lovely ring information, but you are giving everyone Nox vision when you push with your ult. Speaking of pushing with Caustic, it always helps to have an Octane for quick rotations to help avoid getting beamed as a big boy. Also, jump padding in and ulting unsuspecting squads literally never gets old. You know, in ranked or competitive though, we like to swap to a Wraith for safe portal rotations. Using Caustic traps at the base of the portal after porting out of a fight makes it a very hard portal for enemies to take advantage of. Caustic also should always get a go backpack in any team comp without a lifeline or a Gibraltar, since his gas allows for easy safe reses. This may go without saying, but Caustic should be the main teammate, picking up knock players. You know, using ring information to set up a strong position in a building with traps and then patrolling nearby is a great way to have a safe fight using only your ult. And so as soon as it gets unsafe, you retreat to your building or you just wipe the team quickly. This can also be done more effectively with Rev Octane as your other teammates. These are just a few of the possible teams that you can make, but you know, we find these particular legends to suit Caustic the most. This beast of a scientist not only stalls out fights longer than any other legend in the game, but he also has an ult that makes you clear the immediate area or die rather quickly. He takes 15% less damage than almost every legend and has two damaging abilities. He pairs well with practically every team comp and really makes playing the game miserable for every enemy that you run into, and on top of that, has some sick skins. He doesn't come without his flaws though, so make sure that you play smart and don't overexpose yourself as you're gonna get fried by every player. You know, it's not hard to hit this guy, so make sure that you use cover as much as possible. If you see a Fuse, kill him ASAP because Fuse can be a real problem for Caustic. Make sure that you're always throwing traps out when you want to control the area that you're in and use your gas to your advantage just like Bangalore by using a digital threat for enemies outside of it. Alright guys, well that about does it for our Caustic guide. You know, he's an awesome crowd controller that with the right engagements can be a huge carry in a fight. This big dude is definitely worth picking up ASAP, as there are plenty of experiments to be done with the player base as high as it's ever been. Once again, this is your motivation guide, Keith Allen. If you guys liked the video, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. Connect with me on my Instagram at your motivation guide. We got so much amazing content coming out. Spread the word. I'll see you guys later. Peace.